Once in a while, we find a very unusual star somewhere out there in our own galaxy, and this time we found another one. We found what's known as a zombie star that also seems to be super, super fast moving. It's a hypervelocity zombie star. Hello, wonderful person. Today we're going to be talking about this star and how the scientists believe it was created, but also why it's sort of important to try to learn more about these stars as well. A star known as LP40-365. So let's talk a little bit more about this, starting with the idea of what's a zombie star. So generally, one of the most commonly studied supernova types is what's known as the Type 1a supernova. This happens when a white dwarf, that's essentially what our sun is going to become in the future, gets just enough mass, approximately 1.4 masses of the sun, to then reach what's known as the Chandrasekhar limit, and to then... Generally though, Type 1a supernova always rely on the idea of a white dwarf getting the mass of about 1.4 masses of the sun. This can be done through a collision with another star, or it can be done by absorbing a tremendous amount of gas from the outer shell of its partner. And there are obviously some other ways as well. But there's actually another type of Type 1 supernova that's slightly less common. Anywhere from about 5 to maybe 30% of all Type 1 supernova create a much dimmer and much less explosive supernova known as Type 1AX. If you'd like to learn the details of these Type 1AX supernova, you can check out this paper in the description below. But the main idea here is somewhat similar. You have a white dwarf that reaches just the right amount of mass to go supernova. But instead of exploding and producing a planetary nebula, something goes wrong and the white dwarf is not actually destroyed completely. As a matter of fact, it leaves behind a large piece that seems to be star-like that then starts moving across space ridiculously fast. This is what we refer to as the zombie star. As of today, approximately 30 such events have been identified across the universe, with the most famous event known as SN2012Z, visible in this picture right here, and the supernova itself is visible right here and it happened in 2012. But it's famous because the scientists were also able to identify the progenitor star located in a galaxy known as NGC 1309. And it looks like all of these events tend to share several features in common. First of all, these are like mini supernova. They're not actually that bright and they're somewhat difficult to find, but are still obviously bright enough to be visible with a telescope. And historically, some of them have obviously occurred in the Milky Way, with at least one event in 1181 that was described by different Chinese and Japanese astronomers back in 1181, still even visible today in certain images from the Chandra telescope. And so occasionally these Type 1 supernova are basically incomplete. They end up leaving behind some sort of a partially charred chunk of matter or some sort of a burned stellar remnant. And this type of a burned remnant is what the scientists discovered back in 2017 and more recently reanalyzed, discovering something else really unusual about this star. So back in 2017, by using some of the older data, the scientists discovered a somewhat fast-moving object that you see right here. A star that's generally referred to as LP40-365, also known as GD-492. The general creation story for the star is somewhat similar. It was probably in a binary system, but it just so happens that as the partner started to expand and as the star started to absorb a lot of mass from it, it reached the Chandrasekhar limit, exploded. But the resulting explosion gave it so much push that it started to move across the night skies at a ridiculously fast speed. It became what's known as the hypervelocity star, with the current velocity estimates being about 850 km per second, which is 3.5 to almost 4 times faster than the speed of the sun around the galaxy. But it's not just the fastest moving star, it also has a lot of other unusual properties. This tiny white dwarf, or the remnant of a white dwarf, also seems to be one of the most metal-rich objects ever discovered. As a matter of fact, this has one of the most unusual elemental compositions of any star discovered. It seems to dramatically lack hydrogen, helium, and carbon, essentially being one of the most metal-rich stars ever discovered. Now remember, in astronomy, metals just mean anything that's not hydrogen and not helium. So in other words, this star does not have much hydrogen or helium, but seems to have a lot of other stuff. And right now, the best explanation for this is that, well, it's essentially a result of a massive nuclear explosion. An explosion that very likely produced a tremendous amount of heavier elements, which then somehow ended up inside this star. And so once again, confirming that it's probably some sort of a chunk of an ancient supernova. or once again a zombie star. But there have been a few more discoveries in regards to this object. First of all, its temperature. It's close to about 10,000 Kelvin and does seem to resemble some sort of a white dwarf-like object. But the scientists in the study also discovered that it seems to have a strange, unusual variation every 9 to 10 hours. A variation that's visible both in optical light and in the X-ray light. And here it implies that the object is spinning, but for such a tiny object, for a white dwarf and especially the one that has just experienced surviving a supernova, such a rotation is extremely slow. So if this object is spinning every 9 hours, this might actually provide a few clues to what may have happened in the past in order to create this particular zombie star. And so once again, this is one of the potential explanations. The white dwarf in this case, as it was absorbing mass from its partner, was also slowly losing some of the rotational power. And eventually, once the supernova occurred, the tiny remnant was not actually spinning as fast anymore. And this of course resulted in the zombie star we're detecting now. But the partner in this case also probably got shot out in the opposite direction and is probably now traveling somewhere outside of our own galaxy, moving in the opposite direction from the star we see here. But unlike a typical Type 1 supernova that usually destroys everything and leaves almost nothing behind, the explosion from the Type 1AX supernova was just not powerful enough to destroy the star itself and left behind two stars, with one of them having a lot of heavy elements and a lot of metallic stuff on the inside. But the observations from this paper also suggest that it left behind some sort of an imperfection that creates some kind of a surface irregularity every 9 hours because of the spin of the star. Something that causes the star to dip in brightness by about 5% every 8.9 hours. And honestly, at a distance of about 2000 light years away from planet Earth, this is probably one of the most intriguing and most unusual stars we've discovered in the last few years. Not only does this represent a survivor of an actual supernova, it also has an unusual composition, it seems to have an unusual rotation, and is moving ridiculously fast on top of this as well. So definitely one of the strangest objects we've seen in the last few years. And to put it in a single sentence, it's a high-velocity zombie star of really high metallicity and somewhat unusual shape that causes it to deepen brightness by about 5% every 9 hours. Which means that it's spinning relatively slowly for its kind. With this also being the closest zombie star to us, meaning that we can now study these objects in more detail and discover exactly what happens to these objects when they undergo a supernova and why certain Type 1 supernova do not actually go as planned. But for now, that's kind of all we know. Check out the paper in the description below, subscribe if you still haven't, share this with someone who loves learning about space and sciences, and maybe come back tomorrow to learn something else. Maybe support this channel on Patreon by joining the channel membership or by buying the Wonderful Person t-shirt you can find in the description. Either way, stay wonderful, I'll see you tomorrow, and as always, bye-bye.